Okay guys, so far we have seen couple of things, right? How to automate the things using Terraform. Terraform was specifically specific to the provisioning your infrastructure, right? And all the cloud component that you need to create. What we was doing there is, if you need anything, right? If you need some specific kind of environments, what you can do is you can write down your scripts, right, in the form of TF. Right, everything is available in the TF site, right, in the HashiCorp site. So you can go there, you can get the template, and you can modify those template according to you and use that, right? And you can do the linting so that you could make it more useful for your future. So if you have to make the same kind of environment, right, you can quickly replicate to the another environments as well, right? So that was one part of automation. You was part of one provisioning of infrastructure using Terraform. Right, so we have gone through basic linting things and basic creation things also. So just go through these all things and come back to me, right, if you have any issues, right? So next we're gonna jump on the Ansible now, right? So we're gonna jump on to the configuration management tool, right? So what is this configuration management tool? Anyone has any idea about it? What does this configuration management tool is? Anyone? Any input? No? When we say managing configuration, right? So this is kind of automation. When we say managing configuration, we are managing all the configuration of the system in a one central location, right? And whenever we need to make any changes, we are making that changes to the central location, and we are pushing those changes to the remote location. Right, that's what a configuration management tool works. It holds all the configurations, right, that we need to change in the destination systems and servers, or if we need to do some installation, we need to make some configuration changes and do such kind of things, even we can use the configuration management tool, right? So it does everything centrally. Right, when we talk about configuration management tool, guys, we have a two kind of configuration management tool available in the market, right? The one is pull based and some are push based, right? When we talk about pull based and push based, right, most of the time if you are going in interviews, right, they will ask you those question: what is the difference between pull based and push based configuration management tool? When I say pull, that means I am pulling some information from somewhere, and when I say push, I am pushing some information to some remote system, right? In the same way, the pull and push configuration management tool works, right? You would have heard more tools in the market. I would say Ansible, I would say Puppet, right? I would say Chef. You would have seen so many configuration management tool in the market. When we talk about Puppet, right, and Chef, those are basically pull based configuration management tool. You have made some changes in the remote server, right, and every system which is called client has one you can say one agent installed on them, and some polling system is configured there ki itni itni der ke baad those system keep on going to those configuration management server. If they find any changes, any configuration changes, they will pull that configuration changes for them, right? This is what called a pull based configuration management tool. That means you made all the changes in the in the central server, right? So whatever the specific time the cron schedule or job is schedule, those agent will go to the master server, we'll see if there are any changes for them, and they will pull those changes, right? That's called the pull based, right? When we say push based, right, the push based configuration management tool are those who do not have any agent installed in the client machines, right? They are either using SSS or some utility to connect with the those remote client machines, right? And they are just pushing their configuration management tool whenever you are instructing them, right? Let's say you have asked to do some changes in couple of server. In push based, what you will do is you will run those script and the changes are done. But in pull based, you have done the changes, you have tested the changes in a but whenever the The client machine will have some time interval schedule. They will check the time and they will pull the changes. That's the small difference between pull-based and a push-based configuration management tool. Any question? So, Ansible is a push-based configuration management tool, right? What Ansible does is Ansible uses one SSH agent, right, to connect with the client machine. So you do not need anything, right? Each and every system in the network has, you can say, SSH agent installed. So Ansible uses that specific SSH agent to connect with the remote machines, right? And does whatever you instruct to it. That's what it is called, the configuration management tool, or which is basically a push based. Right, the good thing I would like to tell you about, guys, is the Ansible comes in two flavor. Right, I think it's, I did draw docs.ansible.com. It's so the docs.ansible.com. So let's go to the Ansible documentation. The document of the it's docs.ansible.com. So what I was doing wrong, I'm not sure. So, right. So the document of the Ansible is pretty awesome. Like, we have with Terraform, right? In Terraform, sometime you can have some bugs, you may struggle for something, but in Ansible the documentation is pretty good, right? Whatever you have to things, you have, you know, you go to whatever you wants to do, right, and get the things and do. I'll show you how. Right, so basically the Ansible comes in a two flavor here, right? I think we have a couple of more features added to that. The first is open source that we basically use, and the second is Ansible Tower, right, which is the GUI based and that is owned by Red Hat itself, right? So both thing can be similar. So if you can work on the Ansible, open source Ansible, then you should be good with, you know, working on the Ansible Tower 2, right? So the version we are going to use is, you know, you can say open source, and you will not get any GUI there, right? That's very simple, right? The next is we have to create playbooks in Ansible, right? When we say playbooks are basically, you know, अगर हम in general life में बात करें तो play क्या होता है? प्ले छोटे छोटे हमारे रोल्स होते हैं, राइट? अगर मैं एक रामायण के प्ले की बात करूं तो आई असाइन मल्टीपल रोल्स टू पीपल, राइट? आई टेक सम रोल, यू टेक सम रोल, राइट? इन द सेम वे मींस सब एक छोटा छोटा रोल करते हैं और एट द एंड इट बिकम्स वन शो, राइट? इन द सेम वे Ansible हैज अ प्ले बुक्स, राइट? यू हैव टू राइट एवरीथिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्ले बुक, एग्जीक्यूट देम टू, यू नो, रन एवरीथिंग, right? It is called a recipe in the, you know, you can call it in the chef, right? In the same way for other environments or other, you know, other modules. The second thing I would like to tell you guys is the documentation of the Ansible is really very good, right? Whatsoever you wants to do, you can do here, right? You can directly jump on to the module index, right? When you go to the module index, right, you see everything here. You see all the list of modules available here in the sequence, right? All modules, cloud modules, clustering modules, command modules, crypto modules, monitoring modules, inventory modules, network modules, notification module, packaging modules. So each and everything is available for available in the Ansible documentation, guys. Remember this. If you want to see all the modules, just click on this all the modules, so it will redirect you to here. So here you will see the list of all the modules that is required. Right? So all the modules here, what exactly you have to do, are available here. Right? But it will become a little bit difficult for you to find which module is particularly we can use. Remember, I would again say, you know, whenever you are stepping in any automation, do step by step. Do one thing first, do second thing first, do third thing first. You know, this is how this works. right? So here we have all the module, but you would like to see some specific module at this specific time, right? If you, let's say, I would just jump on the packaging module first, let's say, because everybody is system admin, so you'll understand it much easier way, right? You go to the package module. Let's say you want to install some packages in some system, right? For every packaging modules, you will see here commands would be available, right? Let's say all the operating system, we have package module here. Let's say Brewer for some Linux system, Blender, Composer, Edge install, Maven artifact, NPN, most of the, you know, installer you will see here. And you can say APK, APT for, you know, Debian system. And what we most basically use is Yum. Yeah, right, Yum manager and Yum repository. So you can directly jump on to those specific package managers or what things you required. It will give you the beautiful documentation of that, how you can use it. It says Yum manages package with a Yum package manager. It gives the synopsis what it can do. It can install, upgrade, downgrade, remove, list packages and group with the Yum package manager, right? This module only works on Python 2. Remember this, if you require Python 3 support, see the DNF module, right? You'll have to see that. And what all the parameters you are going to use, guys, it will show you beautifully here. And what all parameter you can use, you can use Boolean parameter here, yes or no, right? You can, you have a choice parameter, you have an auto remove parameter, yes, no, right? You have bug fix here, right? If bugs are coming in future, in the same way, what all things you can do, you will get here. You, if you want to list some packages, things is here, right? If you want some security thing, something to skip, something to apply, if you want to use the stats, most basically you will use this, you know, this parameter here. Upsend means you will install the package, install means you will install, upsend means you will uninstall, install means you will install, latest means it will update if there are any updates on it, present means is also installed, remove means also absent. Right, you'll see the description here also, right? That's a pretty good documentation, you know, explanation of the Ansible. And if you come down, guys, you will see the examples also, right? How you can use those examples beautifully, right? It will give you each and every examples here. You see here, if you want to install the latest version, you have to module likeway. If you want to list the packages, you can do it like way. So each and everything you will see here, you will see that step by step things, right? And one more thing, Ansible uses YAML language, right, which is called the Jinja 2 languages basically, right? YAML language, it is basically written in the Jinja format, right? That's what most of the file you will see in the J2 format. The variables will be in the J2 format here, right, which is called the Jinja 2 formatted, right? And most of the files, the language written here is YAML, right, which is the plain text language, everybody can write it, but you have to take care of the spaces here, right? You that's what I would say, practice will need it more here, otherwise you have written everything fine, you will see the error. So that's what we have to learn, how we write these modules here, how, where the module is starting, where the module is finishing, right, where the, how you are giving the modules, how we are giving the modules argument. You have to take care of these all things, guys. So that's also pretty essential to learn in Ansible. Let's quickly go with Ansible installation first, right? The second, we will see how to use the ad hoc commands, right? So even, right, we talk about the modules. So I have just started talking about the modules, but we have capability of using the Ansible as an ad hoc module, right? We will see that how we can use it as a ad hoc module first, right? So I do have two boxes here. One is Ansible and the another is Ansible client. So jump on here and be root here, right? So just type in here, install Ansible in RHEL 7. So it will directly take you to the, I think it should be an RHEL 8, maybe. Remember it, RHEL 8, somewhere you may have the DNF also in place of Yum, so you'll have to take care of those things also, right? So let's go to the Ansible installation documentation. So I'm taking it there. You could see it easily. So every kind of installation you need, guys, would be available here. What is the operating system you're gonna install it? What is the prerequisites for that? Right, where you are going to install it. So everything you get here. Right, let's say we are a Linux admin, so most of the time we have to do it with the Linux also. Right, so the first it says if this is Fedora, you can run the DNF install Ansible. If this is RHEL or CentOS, you can use yum install Ansible. Right, it says sudo subscription manager repo enable Ansible this. I don't think if okay, that's fine. The second it says enable the Ansible engine repository for RHEL 7 and run the following command. And at the end you have to click, otherwise the another method you have is you just clone the repo, right? That's basically you are doing it from source, right? Even you can see RPM for the current supported version, RHEL, CentOS and Fedora are also available in the EPL repo. You can go here in the EPL repo, you can get them also, right? Otherwise you can, the third option you have, guys, is you just clone this repo. You already know git. Log, move to the Ansible folder, run make rpm, and it will create rpm for you at the when you have all the rpm available in this build location, rpm build Ansible. This is telling you how to make the rpm, right? If you have built the rpm sometime from the source code, so you would be familiar with these things. So that's what they are making, creating the rpm from source and installing the Ansible. So why we need this, guys? If sometime you will fail issue, like, you know, you must be familiar with the architectures, right? We have a different type of architectures available, right? Let's say if one architecture does not support these RPMs, then what we should do? So what you can do is you can build, this is the source code, from that source code you can build your RPM in that specific box and install the RPM. So that will remove the architecture independent option basically for you. Let's say most of the time, if you have, guys, ever worked with the PHP and something, right? So what you do basically is you build the PHP from source, because if that is not supporting any architecture, so just take that RPM in that specific architecture, right? Build that from the source code and install it. So that's how you can make it here also, right? So let's try with this. I believe this is not going to work, maybe, or it is going to work. So it says direct to do it for RHEL RPMs for the RHEL 7 and are available from the Ansible repository. Okay, Ansible repository we have. So let's go ahead and run these commands here. If not, then we will take it from the Ansible repository itself, from the EPL repo. I believe everybody would be familiar with the EPL repo too.
सर ये कमांड चलेगी नहीं,
आई बिलीव नहीं चलेगी. यप यप, आई सी दैट, आई जस्ट वांट टू शो दैट वी डोंट हैव सब्सक्रिप्शन, बट इट मे बी लाइक द एनसी, यू नो, वी हैव अ गू, आई मीन AWS मशीन्स हियर, वी माइट गेट सब्सक्रिप्शन टू. सो यू कैन सी दिस हैज रन सक्सेसफुली. Right, the MDNF plugin, etc plugin, and something it has done. So let's run the okay, that's for RHEL 8, we don't need it, right? And go ahead and try to install the Ansible. If this doesn't work with DNF, Ansible, yum, then go ahead and do the DNF. Just give it a yum clean all. Okay, it doesn't find package here. So let's go to the EPL repo, get the EPL repo here from here. We are in RHEL 8, so let's copy this EPL repo. I don't want this. Copy link address. So I mean take wget. So we have EPL available, so let's install it. So we are done with this. So let's go to etc yum.repos.d. You will see the repo here, right? So let's give it install. So now you can see we already have repo available here for EPL now. So let's give it a try now. Just give a yum clean all just to clean up the cache. So you see Ansible installation has, you know, is in process, so it will get, I think, success in a couple of seconds, right? So that's how easy to install the Ansible. So you have many way to do it, right? If you have subscription, if you have RHEL subscription from your organizations, so you can use these two commands. If you don't have, if you want to use the without support, you can go to EPEL. Even if you want the architecture independent package, and if you want to make it from the source code itself, go ahead and get the source code and build it, build your own RPMs and install it, right? That's how you can install Ansible, guys. And once you are done with installation, right, only we need master, you know, Ansible in one single node, in the remote node. Remember this. So as soon as you install the Ansible, you can verify the RPM here using rpm-qa pipegraph-i Ansible. So it will show you the installed package. If you want to see some configuration file, you can quickly go ahead and you can use the rpm-qf. You can query over the file and check. Oh, I think it's qi. Right, you can query file, and you can run many commands here. You can see when it was installed, and if you want to see the configuration file, so many things you can get the things from here, right? And the next is, as soon as we install the Ansible, right, and there is one configuration folder, one folder is created which is called the etc Ansible, right? And you will see by default one folder here which is called the roles, and the second is host, and the third is ansible.cfg, which is basically called the configuration file of Ansible, right? The host file is inventory file. Inventory file is where you will define your host, right? I will discuss about it, and we'll go in deep about the host file also. For now, just remember, host file will be the inventory file for you. Inventory file means if you have large number of servers, right? Large number of, you can say, DB server, and you know, web servers, application server, you can create the groups of host in the host file. So whenever you will run some, you know, you will run the Ansible commands, Ansible will read these host, this inventory file, and will run those commands, whatever you have specified in those specific server, right? That's how it is. That's how the host file is. We will discuss about it more.